distinguished doctors present here. It's about 5 months I have been associated with GMCGM and looking after the portfolio of health amongst the responsibilities that are given to me. Diabetes actually is one of the major programs the MCGM is thinking to implement with our other programs like anti-malaria and now the our drive against MDR and XDR-TB. We have a huge setup in the city of Mumbai. Probably we do not have our parallel in the country as far as municipal corporation's role is concerned in providing primary, secondary and tertiary healthcare. As per the Act, we are expected to give only primary care. However, MCGM is giving secondary and tertiary care also, and besides that, for primary health, we have about 167 dispensaries, and we also have health centers. We also have about 28 maternity homes, 18 peripheral plus 5 specialist hospitals, 4 medical colleges, and the 5th one will be hopefully with, starting from July 15. That is, Cooper Hospital is getting converted into a medical college, and I hope we will get all the permissions from MCI. As far as the role of private sector is concerned, along with the MCGM, I think we can follow a model that we have started following for XDR and MDR-TB. As you are all aware that MDR-TB treatment is costing about 1,50,000 and XDR can go up to 5 lakhs. The entire cost of treatment is provided free of cost by the MCGM hospitals. And we have requested the private doctors that if they diagnose such a patient, they can direct the patient to us so that we can provide him free medicine. However, if a doctor wants that the patient, because of many reasons, is afraid of coming to the municipal hospitals, we are even ready to supply medicines at the doctor's place so that patient can collect the medicines free of cost directly from the doctor's place. So same kind of model probably we can implement for our fight against diabetes also. At present, we are providing oral medicines free of cost from all our dispensaries or another peripheral hospitals also. However, insulin is provided only from the peripheral hospitals and the medical colleges. We may have again to think about providing insulin at the dispensary level. Although we are spending about 3,000 crores every year in the MCGM for the medical facilities, we have a strong administrative and political backing in the MCGM, and they have never set for anything new that is to be implemented in the healthcare. It might take some time actually to put the things in place, and we also have to look at the financial burden. As far as the information given by the Honorable Minister sometime before, regarding the scheme of Government of India of providing free medicines, the government has actually identified now MCGM in the first phase. They have already included MCGM in the first place, and an amount of about rupees 8 crores they have already placed at our disposal. However, it will again take some time, almost about a year or so, to establish this system to work with full potential and capacity. But we have a very, very committed team of doctors, be it our dispensaries or maternity homes or in all our peripheral or medical colleges. In fact, our medical colleges is something that we can boast about. So I think with the help of doctors in the private sector and MCGM network, we should be effectively able to deal with the issue of diabetes. As regards to the role of counseling that was mentioned sometime before, at present we have a helpline for diabetes, but we do not have counselors only for diabetes, which we may have to think about. Again, it is a cost-related thing, but probably instead of creating new posts of doctors, we may think of having some other model, like the other model that we have already introduced, we noticed that all our peripheral hospitals, the occupancy of beds, we have about 12,000 plus beds in the MCGM, where our medical colleges are having an occupancy ratio of anything between 95 to 125%. The peripheral hospital is having about 45 to 55%. At times, the best performing hospital in the periphery is having about 70%. The main reason was we were not getting enough gynecologists, we were not getting enough child specialists and the anesthetists and the surgeons. Because in our present model, we only have mostly MBBS doctors or doctors with some diploma, and all other services are to be provided by consultants whom we are paying hardly 1,000 rupees or 5,000 rupees or 10,000 rupees. But we have now come out with a model, and we have already issued an advertisement in papers about 3-4 days back, that we are now offering 75,000 rupees flat on any doctor who is willing to join us. He will be putting 8 hours duty, and after that he is free to do private practice or whatever activities he would like to do. So I hope probably this model would work. So if this model works, then probably on the same lines we can also think about providing counselors, that instead of appointing them full time, which probably we may not be able to sustain for a very long time. Because although now there is a probably a conception in the minds of people that Mumbai Mahapalika mein kya bahut paisa hai. It is not so actually. We are not aware ki what would happen to the octroi. And our establishment expenses are going at almost 25% rise every year, whereas our income is increasing at the rate of 10% only. So there is a huge gap. And maybe in next few years, if this 7th pay commission comes, then probably we may have to again think of imposing some more taxes on you. So, but however, I think probably we are the only one at present spending almost 3,000 crore rupees only on medical field. And there is always a possibility of increasing this budget. With other hardships that we may have to face, we will not compromise with the health services. The Honorable Minister has some time back also, this may be some deviation from our main topic, but I would like to give you some information that he was referring to a patient who, rather her parents refused to put her into government hospital for delivery. We are developing new hospitals, one in Bhagwati, which will have about 1,200 beds. The other is Govati Shatabdi, that is being redeveloped for 1,200 beds. And we are also coming out with 650-bedded super specialty hospital in Bhandup. So wherever we are constructing or reconstructing our new or old hospitals, we have decided to keep one dedicated floor as a paying ward, where it will be quite affordable as compared to any private facility given in the city of Mumbai. Because as far as our health facility and healthcare is concerned, we charge you very nominal. Even OT charges for operations like angioplasty, we hardly charge about 5 to 10,000 rupees. And in some cases, we do it free of cost also. So I hope this model will also work, and probably that will also attract more patients to an affordable health care. As far as diabetes is concerned, whatever, if patients are coming to you and if you find that he is not able to afford the cost of insulin, these patients can be directed to MCGM hospitals. For XDR and MDR-TB, we have already started having such kind of dialogues with the private practitioners, and we all have already so far held two such programs. Where we have invited doctor from the private field, and along with the MCGM doctors, we are discussing the issues with XDR and MDR-TBs and how to tackle it. The same thing we can follow for diabetes also, and we can also have sessions like this from the doctors in the private field with MCGM doctors at various places in Mumbai. For XDR and MDR, we have decided to carry out this program for one full year, at least twice a month. The same thing we can do for diabetes also, to create awareness. Secondly, as far as diabetes is concerned, we right now do not spend much on the IEC activities, which I think is one of the essential aspects. We may have to think of creating some budget provision for IEC activities for diabetes, and probably for the from some of the companies who are taking active part with MCGM in the corporate social responsibility, there are few companies who are actively supporting us. So with their help, if we can do so, and again for XDR and NDR TB, a celebrity like Mr. Amitabh Bachchan has agreed to shoot a film for us for 1 minute duration and 30-second duration for publicity. So likewise, we can also look at the possibility of some celebrity who would be willing to work with us, and that can be a very good IEC activities. So with the help of doctors in the private field and MCGM working together, and with the repeated efforts, I think we should be able to tackle this issue of diabetes. If you have any questions anytime, or if you want any help of MCGM establishments anytime, you may be always free to consult us anytime. I am also available almost daily in my office. You can meet any of our deans or professors or heads of the department in various institutions. Or we have chief medical superintendent and the medical superintendents of our peripheral hospitals. You are free to come and have a dialogue with us. And I am very hopeful, and I am sure that together we can tackle this issue. I once again thank for giving me an opportunity to come before you and share my thoughts. Thank you very much.